First of all, do you remember much about your time working on the Time Monster?
I remember working with John Pertwee and Katie Manning. I remember getting terrible giggles when we got into the studio because everyone suddenly got their costumes on. You know, there were people with you know, colanders on their heads and tea strainers over their eyes. In fact, I giggled so much. I think I got told off. John Pertwee told me off, but I was very young.
Because I read that you were, that there was another actress going to play your part, and you were cast quite late because she was late for rehearsals. Or does that ring a bell? That you were kind of a late.
I don't remember.
No, no. I read it, and I didn't know whether it was true or not. That you were sort of.
I don't think that's true.
I don't think it's true.
No. I remember going for the interview for it.
Right.
Getting it.
Okay.
But I remember going up for the interview to play the doctor's sidekick.
Oh, right.
Now, which one was it? I can't remember.
Could it be before you were in that?
Yes, I mean, before I was in it. I was straight out of drama school. And so I suppose it would have been in the early 70s.
Okay.
I don't know who.
Well, Joan Grant.
Elizabeth Sladen. She got it.
She got it after Joan Grant.
Yes.
Caroline John.
Because I remember being incredibly upset that I didn't get the part. But then I got Bouquet of Barbed Wire.
Yes, which is
later, which was sort of.
So do you remember John Pert? Do you remember Roger Delgado, who played the master in that at all?
I do remember him. I remember being terribly impressed by everyone because I was a young.
So was that your first, was it your first TV role?
It was one of my first TV roles.
Right.
Indeed, it was. Yes.
All the Atlantis
and all the set collapsing.
Yeah.
I remember that being quite problematical because I think they could only do it once. You know, you can't rebuild these things. Couldn't rebuild these things quickly. I mean, John Pertwee was very, very nice to me. Very nice. And I loved his doctor. He was one of my favourite doctors because he had such humour. And I personally feel, and I don't know whether I'm stepping outside I should say, I personally feel the doctor should be older. I know why they cast younger, particularly this latest guy, and I'm sure he's a lovely, lovely actor, and he's terribly good looking. But in my mind, the doctor is an older, wise man, a wise man of the universe.
Exactly. I think he should be like a father figure. And also,
yes.
Lots of sort of running around. They say they cast him because he needs something to run around, and you don't necessarily have to run around as the doctor. Let the assistants do that, let the other people do that. You're sort of standing there in a figure of superiority, aren't you? Authority.
Yes, you are because you're ancient, you're centuries old.
Exactly.
I mean, you know, maybe the next incarnation they might go for why not have a woman?
Would you go for that? Would you?
Like a shot, but I'm sure they wouldn't have anyone my age playing.
Have you been asked, and would you go into Doctor Who, the new series, in any role?
Oh, of course. I think it's so well written now, too. You know, I think it's been taken into another realm by his name.
Russell T. Davies,
yeah. Wonderful writer.
It's never been this popular. It's incredible, isn't it?
I know, but he's just wonderful. But I still come back to that thing of the doctor. I'm not saying that he should be very, very old, but that he should be have a mature quality about him.
A certain age. When you were doing Doctor Who, did you treat it sort of, remember giggling, but was it, were the actors treating it seriously, or was it just like a sort of children's show at the time?
Very serious.
Right.
It was a hugely serious thing because it was so popular. So high to order. Those were the days when the ratings were incredibly high. I mean, you know, Bouquet of Barbed Wire got 26 million people. You don't get those sort of ratings now, you know. It's a different world now. It wasn't the competition. So Doctor Who was a very good job to get, I remember. And I remember being really pleased to get it. I remember, I think I quite liked my costume because I was a sort of princess.
Yes, you were a handmaid.
A handmaid.
To Ingrid Pitt. Now, do you remember?
I remember Ingrid Pitt because, of course, she'd been a Hammer Horror
actress.
Yes.
So I'd seen her in, on films. I was very impressed with everybody.
Did you think the exposure did you good? I mean, go on to other roles because of that, do you think? Or was that sort of...
I think it's you know, it's one brick on another brick on another brick. And that's how it went then. That's how you literally build careers like that. And I was very lucky because I think I did a lot of television in those early days, and I think it was the golden age of British television because of, not because necessarily because of the actors, but because of the directors and the writers that were involved in television. They were hugely creative people.
Now, just talk quickly about this. This sort of radio show thing, how has this been to rehearse compared with normal play? Presumably much easier, I'm imagining it.
That's a very interesting question. Because in fact, the first time I did it with Christopher Timothy. Yes, they've had lots of different actors in, and we in fact had, because we were new to it, we had 2 days. But I know the idea is to get people in. Oh, and then Sue Holderness took over from me. She went, she did it after me, and she just came to watch it, and she only had about 2 hours. But she watched it twice, and I think the idea is that people will come in sort of with an afternoon to be able to learn how to do it in. So I'm sure they'll come up with some sort of page of bullet points that you style you have to stick to. You
is
know?
It? I mean, I is it? Has it changed much in radio in the sense of creating those pictures through the word? Is it, you know, all the stuff about turning the pages away from the mic and that kind of stuff?
No, that's all the same.
It's all the same,
radio,
isn't it?
I think radio does have that kind of old fashioned.
The archer's time clomping along the feet in the whatever it is.
Oh, the sound effects are just the same. That hasn't changed at all.
Because they can steal the show, or is the guy's doing it, doesn't it? Steal it.
It's just, but it's carriage. So funny to watch, you see. But although we do try to keep Agatha Christie's story alive.
Yes.
I mean, there would be a great temptation to send it up, which is what we don't do. What we do is to stay in the period, you know, with the accents, upper middle class. But she, you know, she wrote upper middle class characters.
Oh, yes, very well. Her stories are very good.
And she was terribly aware of the class system, Agatha Christie.
Yes,
she's fascinating. But I mean, you know, that's why some of her expressions don't work today. You know, those...
Exactly. Queer. And
queer. But we've left the queer in. I say queer.
I mean, people should know.
I know, and I think there's a gay in there as well. But sometimes some of her expressions really scream of,
non-PC.
The
last thing, okay. Bouquet of Barbed Wire, which you touched on, is that the thing that you look back on as the thing you're most glad that you did?
Well, it was a wonderful part.
Is it Frank Finley? Was
yes,
it? No, because it was a bit. It was just before I was a bit too young. I suppose,
you would have been
to be allowed to watch it.
No, it looked quite raunchy.
It did look quite raunchy.
Yes, so, everyone says that. I mean, I suppose from the time, it looked like a teddy bear. It had just been out on DVD.
Right.
Compared to what you watch today, but for its time, I think it was quite the shocking thing, and I always say this about it, which still would be shocking. It's actually about a father who fancies his daughter.
Exactly. Yes.
I mean, you never ever see anything. No. I mean, there's nothing ever happens.
No.
It's just all inferred.
Yes.
It's from a book.
Yes. But there's sort of that's almost more. Erotic is probably the wrong word for that situation, but that can be more erotic than full-on, you know.
Yes. I mean, the
suggestion is always more exciting, isn't it, than seeing it, which is the mistake people perhaps make now, is everything is full-on.
Yes.
You lose the you know, excitement.
I've heard they're redoing it. I don't know whether they'll be able to what's happening with the ITV network. I don't know what's happening, but if they do redo it, I still think that theme will be shocking. Might be even more shocking now because we're almost more aware of incest and paedophilia. It's a big sort of 20th century issue, isn't it? Whereas I don't know whether it was quite so on the agenda as it was in the 70s.
No.
As it is now, I don't know, in the 70s. But, you know, the actual story was about the disintegration of the family.
Yeah.